Hello there, and welcome again. Not on this one, I remember talking about my DVDs and talking about films I'd like to review. That being this one, Striking Distance, good film with Bruce Willis. I say it's more of a thriller as well as an action film. I'm not normally into psychopaths and killers and all that, but this one is more of a thriller and it's more of an action film. You start off with Bruce Willis as a cop going after a serial killer. He goes around killing women. One bloke is chasing the bad guy, they have an accident, and his father is found dead. I say it again, he's found dead. And you think the killer has killed his dad. But this film, being Striking Distance, has a lot of twists and a lot of turns on the way. You kind of feel sorry for Bruce Willis' character in this, because he gets a lot of shit, and I mean a lot of shit, bear with me. Yeah, he gets a lot of shit in this film. To start off, let's say, a couple of years later, and he's no longer a cop, he's now like a beach dad. That's right, he's a beach dad. You get one guy, he's a bit of a dick with him, you always do, don't you? And he meets a beautiful woman, who becomes his partner. Played by the beautiful woman herself. You ever watch Sex in the City TV series? You can find her. She's in the film. Her from Sex in the City. That does roll over in this, and this film, as you know, was in 1993. So it's a dud-un. The killer's still alive, and he's killing people on the way. But before any of this, I'm going ahead of myself here, there was one guy who was his mate. He was a cop, and he was getting the brain for this. Yep, he was getting the brain. So, as I say, he was getting the blame and he takes his own life. He jumps off a bridge into water. I say it again, jumps off a bridge into water. And as I say, a couple of days later, he got the boot. And there's one guy in it who did him a lot of shit. You might remember him. He was the actor, remember House 3? The one who paid Matt Taker, the killer. Well, that was him. He used to die, did some a lot of shit in this film, in a lot of films. And yeah, he did some a lot of shit in this film. So like I say, he's now a lifeguard, and he's riding boats, and there's a good shootout in it where he's chasing some bad guys, and he's shooting them here and there and everywhere. So it's that good film, and he does fall. He falls for the girl in the film, the one that sets in the city, falls for her. So it's more of a feel, he's killing women and he's basically toying with Bruce Willis. He's toying with him because his dear friends, right, I'm not making this up, he has girls in his past and the killer basically is killing his dear friends and rubbing it in his fucking face. He's even his ex-dear friends, let's say, and he's leaving bodies here and there. So this basically shows what an evil bastard he is in the film. So you've got his mate, and basically they're having an argument in the film. There's one guy in it who takes a lot of shit, like I said. So yeah, it's not a bad film, Striking Distance, you know, 93. Popular film, not a lot of people talk about this film now, except for me, because it's a very underestimated film. And for Bruce Willis, it's a damn good role. The dude gets knocked out, who's Bruce Willis's bird, the dude that sets in the sitter. And Bruce Willis gets caught, and remember the guy who both have killed himself, he jumps off the bridge? He's not dead. I say it again, he's not fucking dead. It turns out he faked his own death, and guess what? Unless he got the blame for it, he was the killer. He was the fucking murderer. Yeah, he was the murderer who was doing the murders. And I like the way he does this because he plays with emotions. He plays with emotions all the way through the film. He's got Bruce Willis, he's got his mate, and he's got his one mate. I think it's his mate, it's his brother who he's fucking with him, man. The other one who's faced his death. Not Bruce Willis' brother, his mate's brother. And his dad comes in. This is where it has a twist to it, because it's all flashbacks of Bruce Willis' dad, right? It turns out the killer didn't kill him. The killer's dad killed him because he knew, right, it's a bit confusing here, he knew that the killer was his son and he wanted to protect his own son. And obviously Bruce Willis' father found out that he was the killer, not Bruce Willis, the killer himself, So the dad of the killer killed his dad with it, and that's what he found out. And he obviously let his son get away, and obviously he faked his own death. So he definitely is a fucked up guy in this. I remember the actor actually, he's been in a few films where he always played these sort of like similar characters or weird characters. He was also in the Sixth Friday the 13th, and he also played a small role in Soccer. Bruce Willis gets away, goes after the bad guy, has a lot of good twists and turns, a good action scene at the end. The fall in water, Bam's electric thing in the killer's mouth, fucking kills him, end of bad guy, manages to do that, sets in the sitter. That's her again. See him there, having a tit snog. And basically, oh, there's a good one here. There's his, sets in the sitter, do from sets in the sitter. And they have to get married, have a kid, and live happy after. I say it again, they live happy after. And I think it's not a bad film for what it is from 1993. Starting Distance. If you ever find it on DVD, pick it up. I got it at a reasonable price. And I love the film. I love the film. I mean, I'm not normally into films with killers and psychopaths, but in my eyes, this was more psychological. It was more suspenseful. It was more everything, and I like Bruce Willis. I mean, I've got him in the original Die Hard, I've got him in Die Hard 2, I've got him in Die Hard with a Vengeance, I've got him in Die Hard 4 AD, or Feed the Die Hard. None of us have not seen his other one. And I do remember Bruce Willis. I remember him in the comedy show, I remember him in Moonlighting. I remember him in Moonlighting. I remember him in Blind Date, Damned and Roll with Jim Brassender. And this one, not a lot of people remember this, and I remember it from 1993 because it's suspenseful. There's a lot of good boat chases in it, you see there, a lot of good boat chases. I almost forgot, almost fucking forgot. The guy who was giving him shit, the one out of House 3. I'm sure they copied this from Cold Block. The scene in Sylvester Stallone, remember the film Cold Block? Because he says a scene to him, says, "I know you've been through a lot of shit, and I imagine you want to smack me one." I can understand. And at first you think, nah, it's all right. And then they're just going to walk off and forget it. He almost does that. He says, nah, it's okay. It's okay. Oh, hang on a minute. Bang! Bucky smacks him one and says, change my mind. I love it. I fucking love it. Because the guy in the film, when you think about it, he fucking asked for it. Only for the fucking film, he fucking asked for it because he was cheating him like fucking shit. I say it again. He was cheating him like fucking shit. So we got a well preferred served, got a very well preserved smack in the tops. Sad to say the actor's no longer with us, with Big Matt Tate in House 3. But good role for him, and it's a good role for my friend Bruce Willis. That good acting role, a lot of good action, a lot of good boat chase scenes in it. And you do feel sorry for Bruce Willis, got through the film, gets treated like shit. But it does have a happy, it has a very satisfying ending. Good role for him. You never see films like this ever again, which is a damn shame, especially for Bruce. Yeah, Starting Distance, 1993. Check it out. Into them. I'll see you later. And be smart, be safe.